It's a great pleasure to be able to speak to you about this video in the session on the CBIE Symposium on Reimagining Internationalization Post-COVID-19. I think the topic of both this session and symposium is a very relevant one. It is time to make the changes that are most needed. Of course, we already have discussed for a long time the challenges that the way internationalization has been going are enormous. We have been becoming too much depending on international students as a revenue source. We have becoming much more concerned about depending on a small number of countries and the risk that has to higher education institutions. We have becoming concerned about the sustainable development goals and in particular climate change and the impact mobility has on those aspects. We have become concerned about nationalist populist trends against global learning for all. And we have also been concerned about racism in international education. But it has all been very much marginal in the debate, which was dominated still very much on how can we increase mobility of international students? How can we increase mobility of programs and institutions? All not so much the essence of the core values of internationalization, which were much more dominant in the 80s and the 90s. Collaboration, exchange, development of intercultural and international competencies. Now, the COVID-19 crisis has made it possible and forced us to a certain extent to revalue what is happening in internationalization of higher education. The danger is that institutions of higher education, governments, and even international educators are wanting to reset the button to before the crisis, continue the way we were working in internationalization of higher education, focusing on a very small elite of students that had a possibility to go abroad to study for degrees, to be participating in study abroad programs, etc., and not paying attention to the fact that that is a very exclusive instead of inclusive form of internationalization. This is the right moment that we can do what several of us have already been preaching for many years, to focus much more on internationalization that is inclusive, that is focused on global learning for all. It doesn't mean that we have to go completely blank on mobility. Interpersonal connections are very essential as part of global learning. The possibility to have contacts with students and faculty and communities abroad is an essential part of what we mean with internationalization. But we have to reimagine different ways that we can arrange that. On the one hand, we can do that by making internationalization much more digital, by setting up more programs of collaborative online international learning, not in a passive way where students listen to faculty from abroad, but in a very inclusive and interactive way where students inside the classroom and outside the classroom from different parts of the world work together in discussion platforms, joint projects, joint articles and assignments, and in that way start to learn to understand each other's way of thinking, the differences in cultures, the differences in perceiving knowledge, etc. I think this is the right moment to make the combination between internationalization and technology much more to the forefront. We can also think about other ways how do we confront students with different cultures at home. We can think about students going into the local communities with a very diverse population. We can bring in those communities into the classrooms. We can think about how we can understand better what is happening in our own cultures with international and intercultural. In that sense, also, we have to be aware that in internationalization, we are not should not ignore the fact that racism is also part of our reality. That we still see that many students from indigenous populations are not having access to internationalization, not by mobility, but also not in the classroom. That there is concern that institutions and white students are not aware about the fact that they, by their attitudes, by their policies, by their way of personal development, are ignoring the fact that they have to be much more aware about the need for interaction with their fellows from indigenous parts, to be on equal terms together. So we have to do a lot of work. It's not going to happen by itself. We, as international educators, have to take the lead in making our leaders in the higher education institutions, in national governments, but also our administrators, our faculty, our students, aware that we have to start thinking about new imaginative ways of internationalization, which go against the traditional mode of purely mobility. Because if we continue to do that, we not only have a high risk that there are financial constraints resulting from our institutions and by that also for our work, but in particular that we will continue to be a very elitist way of internationalization that increases the inequality in the world instead of it is trying to make things different. I wish you all a nice conference, a very interactive way of interacting about the reimagining internationalization and new forms of education abroad for students. This is again the right moment, and the fact that I am able from Amsterdam to speak to you on this topic in the conference is one of the examples of how we can be much more using technology to make interaction internationally and interculturally possible. Thank you very much.